Doug Riseborough has turned the Flames roster upside down, including being part of the largest deal in National Hockey League history, as he made a deal with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Former 50-goal scorer Gary Lehman, Craig Berube, defenseman Michel Petit, and Alexander Gadynyuk, along with goaltender Jeff Reese, are the newest Flames. Tonight, these new-look Flames host the Chicago Blackhawks. The other day, in his first game as a Hawk, Rob Brown showed not only good scoring ability, but the great hands that a playmaker has.
Well, he took a lot of hits to make some plays, but he did set up Jeremy Roenick for the winner, and he set up Brent Sutter a few times. He made some brilliant passes. And the quote is, maybe I need some pushing, maybe I need a good kick in the butt. The key words in that statement, maybe twice.
And a man who hasn't given a goal in his last two games is ready to start for the Blackhawks.
12 wins, 10 losses, 5 ties, and a 2.53 goals against average with 4 shutouts, leading 4 shutouts. And Mike Vernon, since 1986, no goaltender's won as many games as Mike Vernon. 178 wins, that's the most ever by any Flame goaltender. But this year, 18-16-6.
Now here come the Flames. Lehman over the line, trying to center. Shot on! Good save by Belfour. As Lehman made a nice pass to Robert Reichel, and Belfour had to come up with a good stop early. Puts McInnes to center. He shoots it in there, bouncing to the net. They score! And Belfour was going to come out and play it, then fought again. It hopped over the stick of Graham, and I think it was Nieuwendyk that poked it in. 1-0 Calgary.
Well, it was a good dump hit by McInnes. He tried to pass first through the defense. It missed, but it was dumped in perfectly. Belfour in no man's land. Thought about playing, decided not to. Thought Graham was going to get it. Sort of relaxed right here. And it hopped over the stick of Graham and right to Nieuwendyk, and he put it in past a startled Graham and Belfour. The puck just hopped over Graham's stick. Belfour in no man's land, anticipating that Graham was going to get to it. And Nieuwendyk beat both players to it, tucked it in on the power play.
Back to the line, it's held in by Smith. Got it to the corner, then it's bouncing loose to Roenick, center and bouncing puck. A shot. Oh, and Larmer had an open side, couldn't tip it in. A great feed from Mateau.
And Mateau gets the puck, bang, across ice. Vernon's down. Over to Larmer, an empty net, and Larmer somehow missed the entire empty net.
Help from Rob Brown, who still centered it even as he was knocked out. Now Roberts is going to have a breakaway. Here's Belfour out, and he managed to run into Roberts, and no shot was taken.
Pulling away, Roberts tried to poke it by Belfour. Belfour came out and took the body, which was a heads-up play. Couldn't get the puck. He might as well make sure Roberts couldn't advance.
Zone, now a feed out to center, and racing away is Reichel over the line. He had to turn out. Peluso dropped the glove with Kite in the other end of the ice. Jim Kite and Mike Peluso square up. Peluso with a left hand loose, swinging away. And he's landing a couple, and Kite is in trouble, and Jim Kite has a big problem with Mike Peluso, who wins a one-sided bout.
In a one-sided affair with Mike Peluso, took his lumps, but I think he injured his knee in the process. His leg seems to be out of position in the right knee. Jim Bearcat Murray out there trying to help him out, and Kite appeared to fall backwards as he was hit hard by Peluso's left. He's being helped off, so tough situation for Jim Kite. 20 games this year, over 100 minutes in penalties. Won the first round pick of the Winnipeg Jets.
And really a fine fella. Most people know he's hearing impaired and has overcome quite a few obstacles to get to the National Hockey League. By Kachera. Kicks it ahead and captured by Larmer. Gets the line, shooting, and a save by Vernon. Just got a tiny piece with a blocker. Into the corner goes Goulet. He came up with it, centering Larmer. He scores! Steve Larmer with a nifty deflection in traffic, and what a pass from Michel Goulet. He put it right where it had to be. Larmer tips it in. It's 1-1.
Well, that was a great pass because Goulet was going away from the play along the far boards, going towards the blue line, reversed the flow back to Larmer right on the money, and it had to be. And he had a narrow opening, and he tucked it in past Vernon after Vernon stopped Larmer from a great blocker save. Roenick takes the defenseman off the puck. Goulet picks it up. Perfect forechecking. Pinpoint accuracy on the pass, and Larmer puts it in this time. Larmer's had 3 quality chances in the period. On his third one, he's charmed. I'm wondering if it's going to be a 5-minute penalty for hitting from behind. And I think it is, because Gilbert was just run over from behind by Roberts. There's still a discussion, and it is a 5-minute penalty called on Roberts, so he's lost for the rest of the game. Roberts has been having a great game. He's been getting a lot of ice
out there. Now in behind, Rob Brown centered it, missing Larmer. Then it came to him. He shot a sub rebound. Vernon! Oh, a great save on Larmer, and then a miraculous save on Rob Brown.
Puck surprised him. He got it up front. It was right on the stick of a Flame player who fanned on it. But right to Larmer, Vernon save, and then the rebound to Brown. The puck too.
Bit his lip, and now he's getting a chance to play regularly, and the points are starting to come. Here's Suter, a long shot, he scores! Gary Suter, as the penalty expired, fired a long shot from the line through traffic, and the Flames lead 2-1.
Well, it won't be a power play goal, but Suter had two quality chances on the power play. As he let two shots rip, but Belfour made the saves. Now this time, though, good work by Fleury to get it loose. Quick spin move over to Suter. The one-timer, a mattress pass to the screen in front. Belfour never saw it. Inside, hit the inside part of the post besides. Belfour had no way he could see this at all. He was screened by Nieuwendyk and Kuchera, and was in and out before Belfour knew where it was. And the Flames take a 2-1 lead on Suter's goal.
Brown at the near point. Up the boards for Chelios. Here's Chelios slipping in front here. Sutter, he scores! Brent Sutter off a nice mattress pass from Chris Chelios. Sutter all alone as the Flames just let him stand in the slot. And the Hawks on the power play tie the game at 2.
Well, we talked about Brown's ability to make those soft little quick passes. Chris Chelios along the boards. And a man moves into the slot. Sutter moved to the puck, got it. It was about a 5-foot pass. He let that quick wrist shot go. Vernon was not set for it. It banged through the legs, and it's a tie game on the power play.
Brent Sutter's 17th of the year, his 300th career goal. Chelios and Keith Brown assisting at 11:28. Took it away. And able to clear it to center. Gilbert a lead. Graham is in. Graham a breakaway. Shoot. Vernon stopped him. The T. Cleared it to the Blackhawk zone. Kuchera couldn't get it past Kerry Wilson. Centering Lehman shooting. And a great shot blocked by Brian Marchman. Now look at they score! It came to the line and Yawney shot one as he was falling. And it's stuck by Belfour. Again, it didn't look like he saw that at all. But Trent Yawney scores against his former team and puts the Flames in front 3-2.
Vernon makes a couple of key saves that kill off the power play. They come right back. Nice feed to Lehman, but a great shot blocked by Marchman. It goes bouncing to the point. Yawney coming on a change, and it's changed directions and hit Marchman's stick as it lay flat on the ice. Yawney takes the hit, lets the shot go, but I think it hit the outstretched stick of Marchman, who was still down after making the first shot block, and it changed directions and beat Belfour to give the Flames a 3-2 lead.
Corner. Hawks look to dig it out. Centering pass to Larmer. Player, I believe Yawney. That was Yawney that was knocked down, and now it's going to be a Calgary power play.
In mid-December, the Blackhawks traded defenseman Trent Yawney to the Calgary Flames in exchange for winger Stefan Matteau.
When I first heard that trade, it was really hard to accept it, but when I first got there in Chicago, it was really good, you know. It's a great city to play for, and it's a great organization, and so far so good, and hopefully it's going to keep going good, and I like it so far.
Actually, becoming a Calgary Flame is like a dream come true for me, because for 3 years I spent here in Calgary with the Olympic team, and you know, I watched the Flames play, and it was always like, you know, boy, someday I hopefully can be playing in the NHL. And then to get traded to Calgary and having spent some time here made my adjustment a lot easier and a lot better for my wife too.
Matteau was sidelined with a thigh bruise until last Thursday when he made his Blackhawk debut.
I feel much better now, you know. The first game against Quebec last Saturday, it was really hard. It was my first game in 3 months, and I felt good, but I was really nervous, and the leg was still bothering me a little bit, but now I feel much better, and hopefully tonight's going to be the night.
Yawney walked out on the Hawks after 3 games, and now he has found a new home with the Calgary Flames.
Well, the one good thing is that my grandmothers have never seen me play hockey, and at the NHL level anyway, and so now it'll give them a chance to at least catch a bus as opposed to a plane to come to Calgary to watch me play. So it works out pretty good. It's nice to have family around, because you look for that support all the time, and I'm really thankful to be here in Calgary.
Matteau is also pleased with his new team, especially because it reunites him with his former junior teammate Jeremy Roenick.
I felt pretty good. You know, I played the full season in Hall with him, and I had a lot of success.
Could have been worse. McGinnis came to take it away. He ran into trouble behind the net. Roenick stole it. Jeremy Roenick works his way free, trying to wrap around. He scores! Jeremy Roenick had also been held without a shot in the first 40 minutes, but he makes his first shot on goal pay as he fought off a check behind the net, completing a wraparound. We're tied at three.
Rob Brown, who doesn't like to dump it in, carried it in, and then Mattel with a good hit on McGinnis, forcing the turnover. Quick stop by Roenick, goes out the other way and snaps it through the legs of Vernon. Vernon was surprised. He was up against the right post, moved back to his left. Quite a separation between the legs, and never got them back together, and enabled Roenick to tuck it in between the legs and give it a 3-3 score.
37 goals for Jeremy Roenick. L4 sweeps it to the near side, and now we have a challenge match behind the net. Peluso won't drop his stick. Berube wants him. Berube dropped his stick. Neither man dropped the gloves. And a whole lot of nothing going on. And it's clear to the neutral zone. Lucille is there. Couldn't advance it. Here's Goulet over the line. A wrist shot and a save by Vernon. Kicked it sharply to the far side, and that's going to do it for the third period. 60 minutes complete. Up we go to OT. Tied at three. Ryan Marchment knocked down behind the net. Still able to knock it away from Fleury, who was ready to shoot off a near giveaway. Now Ranheim in the corner. Paul Ranheim gave it to Reichel, trying to center one. That hit Marchment into the far circle. A shot and a save by Belfour on a Fleury spinning shot. And back come the Hawks. Dirk Graham to the line, trying to split the defense, unable to do it. Gary Lehman pokes it into the Blackhawk zone. Quickly back to center, though, is Lemieux. Down to the flame line, shooting, and a save by Vernon. Cleared it to the far board. Graham is there, centering Hudson. They score! Hawks win! Hawks win! Mike Hudson scores the winning goal in overtime. Dirk Graham with the steal and centering pass. And the Blackhawks have beaten the Flames for only the second time in 5 years. Two in a row for the Hawks on this road trip, and can you believe that the Hawks, who have only 6 wins on the road all year now are 3-1-1 in the last 5 road games.
Lemieux with the wrist shot, loved by Vernon. He puts it around the boards to Graham. Graham back out front to Mike Hudson, the one-timer off the post and in, and the Blackhawks win in sudden death. Sudden life for the Blackhawks, sudden death for the Flames. Vernon, weak clearing attempt, kept in. Good read by Graham. That pinpoint accurate pass right on the money. And Hudson gets his second goal in as many games on this road trip. And elation on the faces of Hudson and the rest of the Blackhawks to win their second straight on this road trip.
Mike Hudson's 10th of the year from Dirk Graham at 203. As the Calgary Flames fall back to a 500 record, the Hawks are now plus 5. They're 23, 18, and 10. And it took us into overtime before the Hawks won it, but I'm not sure why there was any doubt. Karnak Talon told us in the second intermission that the Hawks, even though they were trailing, were going to come back and win this game.
Well, I hate to say I told you so. Not very often I get the feeling. Tonight I had the feeling. They were due. They were playing so well.